For this conceptual photo, I started with three different images here. I have two images with these tennis balls shot separately, and this third image with this half of lemon. Before taking a shot like this, which will end up in a composition, you must make sure you shoot the photos from the same perspective or from the same point of view, if it's possible. It's good to use a tripod for this kind of shot because otherwise, when you are working in Photoshop, you realize that the photos will not match properly, and this is because you use different perspectives. So for example, if you take the first shot at 50 mm, you should maintain the same zoom level when you are taking the second or the third photo. And you also have to choose manual focus and take all the shots with that setting on your lens. Right, so let's get back here. The first thing I'm gonna do is to bring all three images into one single document by opening Photoshop, choosing File, Scripts, and Load Files into Stack. Click Browse, select all three images, and then click OK. I will rename this to Ball 1, this one to Ball 2, and the third one to Lemon. And also, I'm gonna bring ball 1 under the lemon. Okay, from this layer, I will need the lemon only. So I will create a selection just for the lemon, and then I will apply a layer mask to hide the blue background. So step 1, let's select the lemon using the quick selection tool. Then click on the select and mask. I'm gonna change the view mode to black and white. Zoom in a bit by holding Z. And enter a value of 1 for the smoothness, just to make the selection a bit softer. And here I'm gonna select Layer Mask, then I'm gonna click OK. And because I'm pleased with the selection, I can right-click on the Layer Mask and choose Apply Layer Mask. And now I have a selection only around this lemon. So now I will convert this layer to a smart object because I will have to resize it and make sure its margins will be placed exactly on the margins of the tennis ball. The smart object will maintain the original resolution of the lemon in case I want to bring it back to the initial size. To make my work easier, I'm lowering the opacity of the lemon, make it transparent, and this is helping me to see the tennis ball much better. You see here, I'm trying to find the perfect place for the lemon to be exactly as I want and overlap the margins of the tennis ball. I can move around with the arrow keys on the keyboard to be more precise with this movement. Then I will take care of the other margin of the lemon just by clicking on the corner point here, holding down Shift to maintain the proportions and making the lemon a bit smaller. Press Enter to apply the changes and then bring back the opacity of the layer to 100%. So now I can select the ball 1 layer, apply a layer mask to it, then take the brush, just hit B for that, by the way. I make sure I'm painting with black, and then I start brushing over the ball 1 layer to hide that part because I don't need it anymore at this point. And with this process, I also hide the left part of this layer because I want to reveal the third layer, which is underneath, and this is the ball 2 layer. So consider this one as a smart move by doing two different things in the same time. And if you enjoy this, please hit the like button under the video. And hey, if you want to ask me a question, you can easily hit me on Twitter at iStalker. So basically, if I hide the bottom layer, the ball 2 layer, you can clearly see that the left side of the ball 1 layer is now hidden. And now I need to hide the bottom part of the lemon, and I will use the pen tool to make a path for my selection here, real quick. Okay, I have the path. Now I right-click inside the path and choose Make Selection, and just hit OK without increasing the feather at this point. I will make a layer mask while holding down Alt to hide the selected area. If I zoom in now, you'll notice that the lemon edge is too sharp comparing it to the ball underneath, so I need to readjust my selection that I just made. So click on the layer mask and choose Select and Mask here in the layer mask properties. I will enter a value of 3 for the feather and also expand my selection just a bit by increasing the shift edge slider value. I am then selecting the layer mask here because I want to add this change to my existing layer mask, and then hit OK. And you can see the difference now if I undo and redo the last step using CTRL+Z. So look at the edge of the lemon now. It looks better and softer than before. Now I want to change the color of the lemon's edge to be more of a greenish color so it will blend in better with the color of the ball. And to do this, I will add a hue saturation adjustment layer and then make it affect the lemon only by right-clicking on the hue saturation layer and choosing Create Clipping Mask. And you can also do this by holding down the Alt or Option key and then clicking between these two layers when this icon appears. I will change the hue slider. I will drag it to the right until I find the perfect green, which is similar to the ball. I think this value of 13 looks great. I think it looks great. The problem is that I applied this green color to the whole lemon and I want it only on the edge, so I will invert my layer mask with CTRL and I and the whole adjustment layer becomes invisible. Then I take the brush, I adjust my flow if it's needed, and I will start uncovering this part of the hue saturation on the lemon's edge. Okay, let's see a before and after. I hope you see the difference. Good, so now, just to make this closer to reality, I want to blur the ball because the edge of the lemon is a bit blurred too, so I will have to make it similar. I will make a copy of the ball one layer using CTRL+J in case of something happens and I want to go back. And I will rename this layer Blur. Let's convert it to a smart object. In this case, I will lose the layer mask, but this isn't an issue as long as I have a backup layer underneath. Now I choose Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur, and I enter a value of 2. This value depends also on the resolution of your document, so it may be different in your case. Let's see the whole image now. Just press CTRL+0 to do that. The image looks so cool now, but there is one more thing I want to do. You see, here I have these small threads on the tennis ball, which are not supposed to be there, and also I have some things in the background, for example, so I need to clean up these areas to make the photo more pleasing for the viewer's eye. To make this happen, I'm gonna make a new layer on top of all layers, and I will call it Clean. And I'm choosing the Healing Brush tool, I adjust the size with the bracket keys, I make sure that I've selected current and below on the new layer, otherwise this will not work, and then I start sampling from pixels nearby to clean up these areas. You just have to press on Alt when you want to sample and then brush over the parts that you want to replace with other pixels. And then you repeat this step over and over again until you are satisfied with the results. Let's clean up the background real quick by using the same procedure. And now if I hide this layer, you can see the difference. And remember, small details are always making a big difference in Photoshop. So the image looks cleaner now, much cleaner. And this is the final look, guys. I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. Please subscribe for more well-explained tutorials. And don't forget to like this video. This will help me grow this channel and keep delivering good content to you. Thank you so much for spending your time on my channel. This is Chris, and catch you in the next one.